Hello students, this is Shruti. Hope you all are good and utilizing your time in study. So today we are going to start our third chapter of the English grammar, that is nouns, numbers and gender. So what we are going to read in this chapter, let's first of all see the subtopics which we are going to read in this chapter. First thing is we are going to read about the singular, then plural, then we are going to read about the uncountable noun and the countable noun. This is all about your the numbers, and then in gender we are going to read about the gender and its four types. So these are the subtopics which we are going to cover in this lecture. So first of all we are going to start with our singular. What is singular noun? A singular noun is a word that names one person, place, things or idea. What it means that if there is only one thing or one person or one place or one idea we are going to represent, then there will be a singular noun. Suppose you are saying city, then it is what? It is singular. If you are saying cities, it means that there are more than one city, so it is not singular noun. So for some example we can take snake. What is a snake? There is one snake, so it is singular. Letter, there is one letter, it is singular. Girl, there is one girl, so it is singular. Hope you have well understand about the singular noun. Now let's move on further. What is plural noun? It is same as the singular noun, only the different is that it has more than one things. What it means? A plural noun is a word that names more than one person, place, thing or idea. It means a plural noun is going to represent more than one place, person, thing or idea. As firstly I have told you, city is a singular because it is representing one place, but cities, it is going to represent different cities or more than one cities. So cities is the plural noun. So letters plural noun is letters. Snake plural noun is snakes. Girl plural noun is girls. Hope you have well understand about the singular and plural noun. So let's revise it first. Singular noun represent the one person, place or things, and plural noun is going to represent the more than one person, place or things. So let's move on further. We are going to read some special rules for plural, how we are going to change the singular into plural noun. So when we will add es to the singular, if the noun ends with sh, ch, double s, s or x. अगर आपका noun sh, ch, double s, s और x पे end होता है तो आप उसमें es add कर देंगे. For example, bushes, watches, passes, buses and foxes. Next, the noun ends with o. अगर आपका noun o पे end हो रहा है तब भी आप उसमें es add करेंगे. For example, tomatoes and potatoes. If the singular noun ends in a consonant and a y, अगर आपका consonant पे singular noun end हो रहा है तो आप y को हटा के उसकी जगह ies लिख देंगे. For example, penny में आप y को हटा के ies लिख देंगे, it will become pennies. If the singular noun ends with an f, अगर आपका singular noun f पे end हो रहा है तो आप f को हटा के उसकी जगह पे ves लिख देंगे. For example, wolf में आप f को remove करके ves लगा देंगे, it will become wolves. If the singular noun ends in vowel and y, अगर आपका singular noun vowel और y पे end हो रहा है तो आप उस पर simply s add कर देंगे. For example, turkey become turkeys. And some more special rules are there. Some nouns do not change at all. कुछ nouns ऐसे होते हैं जो आपके change नहीं होते. For example, deer to deer. Deer will always become deer in plural also. Fish. Some nouns changes into different words. कुछ noun क्या होते हैं वो different words में change हो जाते हैं. Child changes to the children. Goose changes to geese. And person changes to people. Hope you have well understand this. And if you have understood it, then I have given some words here. Loaf, blueberry, monkey, wish, job, deer, sandwich, tomato, person, mice, man, woman. Means I have given you these words, you have to change it into the plural noun. So hope you have get it about the singular and the plural noun. Now let's proceed on further. We are going to read about the countable and uncountable noun. All nouns can be classified into two groups. सारे nouns को हम दो group में classify कर सकते हैं, countable and uncountable. Before starting the definition, I am going to tell you, from the word itself you can recognize what it means. Countable means the things which we can count, and uncountable means the things which we cannot count. Countable nouns are the nouns that can be counted. It means countable noun वो noun होते हैं जिन्हें हम count कर सकते हैं. We can add a, n और a numbers before a countable noun. हम countable noun के आगे a को add कर सकते हैं, n को add कर सकते हैं या कोई भी number add कर सकते हैं. Now for example, a dog. Dog के आगे आप a add कर दिए, 4 seasons. It is countable. An idea, it is countable. Uncountable nouns are those nouns which cannot be counted. Uncountable noun वो nouns होते हैं जिन्हें हम count नहीं कर सकते. We cannot add a, n or a numbers before an uncountable noun. हम uncountable noun के आगे a, n और a नहीं लगा सकते हैं, कोई भी number नहीं लगा सकते हैं. For example, rice. We cannot say a rise or 10 rises. Rise होता है तो हम 10 rises नहीं बोलते, a rise ही बोलते हैं. Lighting, lighting के आगे हम a नहीं लगा सकते या 10 lighting नहीं लगा सकते या n नहीं लगा सकते. So आपका countable noun count हो सकता है, uncountable noun count नहीं हो सकता है. और अगर आपको difference पूछा जाए तो countable noun के आगे आप a, n और कोई भी number लिख सकते हैं, but आप uncountable noun के सामने a, n और किसी भी number का use नहीं कर सकते हैं. Hope you have well understand this topic. So let's move on further. Our next topic and the last topic of this chapter is noun gender. Now what is noun gender? Noun gender is of 4 types. Masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender and the neuter gender. It means हमारा जो gender topic हम read करने जा रहे हैं वो 4 parts में divide है. कौन से 4 part में divide है? Feminine, masculine, common and the neuter. Now let's move on further. First of all, we have to know that what is masculine gender. A noun that refers a male is said to be a masculine gender. For example, king, boy, man. The noun which is going to refer whom? A man is or a male. Agar aap किसी नाउन को रीड आउट कर रहे हो और आपको उससे ये पता चल रहा है दैट दिस वर्ड इज़ गोइंग टू रिप्रेजेंट द मेल, देन देयर विल बी अ मैस्कुलिन जेंडर. फॉर एग्जांपल, यू हैव सीन बॉय, मैन और अ किंग. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन फर्दर टू द नेक्स्ट, फेमिनाइन जेंडर. अ नाउन दैट रिफर्स अ फीमेल जेंडर इज सेड टू बी अ फेमिनाइन जेंडर. इट मीन्स ऐसे नाउन जो फीमेल को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं वो फेमिनाइन जेंडर है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, क्वीन, गर्ल और वीमेन. Now the next, common gender. A noun that refers to either male or female is said to be a common gender. ऐसे words जिन्हें पढ़ के हमें ये नहीं समझ में आता या हम ये कह सकते हैं वो एक group होता है male और female का, वहाँ पर क्या होता है? Common gender. For example, student. अगर आप student बोल रहे हो तो आप ये नहीं बता सकते ना student में girl है या boy है. It means there is common. दोनों हैं, students में girl भी आती है और boy भी आते हैं. So that is common gender. Hope you have understand the common gender. Now our last gender is the neuter gender. A noun that refers to a non-living thing is called the neuter gender. ऐसे noun, ऐसे words जो non-living things को represent कर रहे हैं वो हमारे क्या होते हैं? Neuter gender होते हैं. For example, table, chair, box. These all words are representing the non-living thing. So these are the neuter gender. So student, again I have given you some words: mobile, actor, books, lawyer, poet, people, doctor, pen. These are some words. You have to classify them according to their gender, ki kaun sa kya gender hai aapka. So student, this was all about our 3rd chapter. हमने इसमें क्या क्या read किया, let's revise first. We have read about the singular, कि कोई भी चीज़ अगर एक चीज़ को represent करती है, कोई भी word अगर one thing, place या idea को represent करता है that is singular. अगर वो more than one represent करता है then that is plural. उसके बाद हम लोगों ने पढ़ा countable and uncountable noun. Countable noun can be counted, आपका countable noun count हो सकता है और countable noun के सामने आपका a, n और कोई भी number लिखा जा सकता है. जाता है। और इसका सेम अपोजिट होता है अनकाउंटेबल नाउन। अनकाउंटेबल नाउन काउंट नहीं किया जा सकता, और ना ही इसके आगे अनकाउंटेबल नाउन के लिए जो हम वर्ड्स यूज़ करते हैं उसके आगे हम ए, एन और कोई भी नंबर को नहीं लगा सकते हैं। और हमारा लास्ट टॉपिक था जेंडर, जिसमें हमने ये पढ़ा था कि हमारा जेंडर क्या होता है। 4 टाइप्स के होते हैं, फेमिनाइन जेंडर, मैस्कुलिन जेंडर, कॉमन जेंडर एंड द न्यूट्रल जेंडर। फेमिनाइन जेंडर फीमेल को रिप्रेजेंट करता है, मैस्कुलिन जेंडर मेल को रिप्रेजेंट करता है, कॉमन जेंडर दोनों को रिप्रेजेंट करता है, और न्यूट्रल जेंडर हमारा नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स को रिप्रेजेंट करता है। होप यू ऑल हैव अंडरस्टैंड दिस टॉपिक। स्टिल इफ यू हैव एनी कन्फ्यूजन देन यू कैन मैसेज मी ऑन व्हाट्सएप और यू कैन आस्क मी एनीवेयर। Hope you all have understand well. Please like the video and subscribe the channel if you have liked it. Good day. Take care.